Welcome to Good Food, and today's recipe is chili. I've topped the chili with some cheese and melted it in the oven. Use your favorite chili cheese. I like pepper jack. You might like cheddar. You might like Monterey Jack. Let's do a tasting to begin with and show you what we're missing here. Oh no, here we go. Now that's so good. Watch and make your own. And please give us a thumbs up, like, and subscribe. Leave some comments and let us know what you think.
Let's get started with the beans. I have soaked my beans overnight, about 12 hours. The reason I do that, one, it helps to reduce your cooking time. But the cooking of the beans do not destroy some enzyme inhibitors. Soaking is essentially the key to removing enzyme inhibitors completely. So for your pancreas sake and your gut sake, it's best to soak dry beans overnight. The first thing I do is put my beans in a mesh colander. You can put it in any colander that you have, as long as the beans don't fall through. I search through them to make sure there's no rocks or any bits that shouldn't be in the beans or bad, rotten beans. After I do that, I rinse them real well. I put them in a pot and cover them with water until it's about, as you can see, this one has already been soaked. I cover them about 3 inches over the beans for the soaking. I've got in the back pot black beans because they cook longer, and I did them exactly like I did this pot. In this pot, we have dark kidney beans, we have canola beans, which is a white kidney bean, and we have pimentos, because actually we couldn't find light kidney beans. But you can use whatever beans you like. You know, I mean, it's up to you. You can also use canned beans if you like, but I don't know if the canned beans have had all their enzyme inhibitors removed. Plus, I think the dried ones, when you cook them, is better. But it is totally up to you. So now that I've got these in there, I have added, this also has 1/2 pound, and all of these ingredients are going to be listed down below, by the way. It has 1/2 pound of each bean. The black beans, it has 1 pound. So I'm going to cook them. I've added 1 tablespoon of salt to this pot and a little over a teaspoon to the back pot. So let's get started. I'm going to cook these on high until they start boiling. Then I'm going to put them down on a medium and let them cook until they're soft. You do not want them falling apart. You just want to put them where you can stick a fork in them, and then you start on your next part of your chili.
For this portion of the chili, we're going to start with a little oil at the bottom of the pan. When it starts to smoke, we're going to add 2 pounds of ground beef and 2 pounds of Italian sausage. This is my hot Italian sausage, by the way. We'll have a link below for the video if you want to make your own or use your own favorite Italian sausage. We'll brown that, and we'll come back and show you how it looks like brown. We've got our meat browned. And as I said before, we had 2 pounds of hot Italian sausage, my own recipe. The link will be in the description below. And 2 pounds of ground beef, and that's all that's in there. And you can see there's fat in the bottom. We want to bind to that fat to make a roux of flour, chili powder, and cumin. And then we're going to slow cook it, and that'll roast the chili powder and cumin and bring out its, I like to say, essence, its real true flavor. Okay, so we're gonna start off half a cup of flour. We're gonna sprinkle that around, try not to get it all in one clump. Works better if I can sprinkle it around. Okay, And now, chili powder. There's 1 tablespoon. 2 tablespoons. 3. Well, that's 3.5, okay? Now we're going to add cumin.
That was 4.5.
4.5? That's good, 4.5. One. Two. Three. Four. Now I want to get a good stir on that and get it distributed good. So we'll start making a roux, and we're going to turn this down. I've used an electric stove, and I'm going to turn it down to 3. You want it to slow cook now and stir it once in a while, because we're making a roux, and that roux cooking, the flour, will roast the cumin and chili powder in the pan while we're doing that. That'll create a lot of flavor to go throughout your chili. Keep stirring it in. It's got to make it thick. We'll add more liquid later. This is going to be our sauce base for the cumin. I mean, for the chili.
It's not coming in clear because it's got that spoon.
Move soon. Can we see it now? I need to keep stirring this, folks. It's not completely mixed yet. I want it evenly distributed. It's going to be kind of pasty right now, maybe a little bit. You can still see there's fat in there.
Mm-mm.
No?
Mm-mm.
When I mash it down, I can see a little bit of fat coming out. I'm still trying to mix it in there. And we're going to do this until you get that kind of nutty smell from the flour and it makes roux. Should be about 2 to 3 minutes. We'll be back when I get done. Okay, now we're going to add our vegetables and let them cook down. We've got that nutty smell starting, and it's going to continue to get a little nuttier as we go along. But we're going to add, we got 2 large onions chopped here.
And that's probably a good 3 cups.
Yeah.
Maybe 3.5.
We got a bell pepper chopped here that's going to add some sweetness to it. You can use green if you want.
Probably a cup.
Got 2 jalapenos. I got large chunks here. I'll put them in here. I've got 6 cloves of garlic. We're going to add that a little later because we don't want that to burn. Okay, so we're going to add that a little later. Serve the rest of these vegetables and get them to start cook. The vegetables are going to reap some water as it does this, and the roux is going to start lightening up. We need to do this to lighten up the roux because this will light give off liquids. Before we start adding other liquids to it, otherwise you might wind up with too much liquid in your chili. Everybody has their own idea how much liquid goes in the chili. You might not agree with what we think. Between my wife and I, we don't quite agree, but we're going to compromise here on this. Like my chili thick, and she likes hers thin.
And her, not thick.
We're going to do something in between. And we're going to let this cook for a couple minutes. And then we're going to stir it again. And keep doing it until the onions wilt. They turn translucent and soft. Okay, our onions are turning translucent. And if you stir, you can see what I'm saying there. All the way through. So it's time to add the garlic. And the onions can finish and the garlic can cook at the same time. Our garlic. Want to get all of it. Don't want to waste any garlic. Garlic is gone. Now we're going to stir that in and continue with our cooking process here. We're still roasting that garlic and the cumin and chili peppers. And this should take about 1 more minute and we'll go to the next step. Now it's time to combine our meat with the beans. Normally I do this the other way around, just the way we've done the beans this time. The beans are in the big pot. Mix this in. We're going to add our salt while we're doing this. And then our tomatoes. Now you chili purists, so you add your beans at the table. Well, we're not Texas chili purists. You can adjust this recipe to your own taste. Now add 3 teaspoons of salt approximately, or 1 tablespoon. Stir that in.
Salt's already in the beans.
Yep. We're going to add 2 28-ounce cans of tomatoes.
What type of tomatoes is that?
They are diced tomatoes. We're also going to make chili cheese fries of this. There will be a video coming up on that. Look at the description down below. When we make it, there will be a link there. And now we're going to need to let it simmer for a few minutes and we'll add some more liquid. We'll be back in 5. We'll try to put 4 cups of bean leftover broth in here to see if it's going to fit. And it looks like it's going to. Let's stir that in and see what we get. And then when it comes to full temperature, we'll be ready to do our taste test. The colors of the different beans and the red peppers and a little bit of green from the jalapeño. Oh, we need to add a few more herbs too before we finish this. Let's finish our seasoning. Okay, we're going to put a scant teaspoon of cayenne in here. And then a heaping tablespoon of basil and a heaping tablespoon of oregano. Get that mixed in and we're going to simmer for 10 minutes and we're going to serve.